Good afternoon. Now, this is about making all IIIF resources searchable and findable. This is not about searching within one object, but finding the objects that are interesting to me or to a certain community. The strength of IIIF is interoperability. And here you can bring together digitized objects from different sources. This is the core, or one of the cores. And in small scale, you can do this manually. We've seen a lot of examples before. But what do you do if there are millions of IIIF objects from hundreds or thousands, maybe one time, institutions out there? How can you find and select objects within this mass? So let's talk about the necessary steps to enable IIIF content retrieval worldwide and cross-domain. This is clearly something that matters to a lot of people here in this room and to others. There was a IIIF discovery workshop at Stanford last June. There's a new Discovery for Humans working group starting this year. You heard this before from Antoine. And you heard a lot of similar or related concerns in the presentations you heard this afternoon, and you will hear tomorrow or the day after. Here are a few examples written out. Rishis and Nunu will talk about, and a lot of other people's too. So where we are, what steps are we have to go to enable content retrieval worldwide and cross-domain? So one step is to make the IIIF resources collectible in a higher quantity. And this goes mostly with the top-level collections. One institution forms a top-level collection, and you can get all their objects from this point. Then make all IIIF resources collectible. I think it would be a good idea to build a registry of all top collections. And then you have one point where you can get all of the IIIF stuff that is registered. And it's interesting to keep the IIIF registry up to date and other collections of manifests of objects. And this is on the way with the IIIF change discovery version 03. What's also to do to make all IIIF resources findable, in my point of view, is to add metadata to feed index and facets to IIIF manifests. In the specification, there's an area in the IIIF manifest where you can store metadata, but this is only for presentation purposes. That's defined there. And it's not to build a search index and to build facets over there. It would be interesting to discuss a basic element set for index and facets, so to say a common IIIF index profile. And of course, there should be additional ways, and there are, to bring in specific formats or element sets for specialized interests to individuals or to communities. This is with the C also link. It's possible, but it's not standardized. I think that there could we do a lot of more. And this common IIIF index profile, I think about the analogy to OAI PMH, where there's said that you have to deliver your data in Dublin Core format, and then additionally you can deliver your data in other formats too. And then it would be possible to create a global search index over all IIIF objects. And would be the starting point to create individual search indexes. Let's imagine there's one researcher that he's interested in in a specific topic and gathers together all the objects he wants to see, and then he can build his own search index, because in the manifest there is linked the metadata with which he can feed his index. We looked at some of the search portals that are out there and saw that regarding facets, there are some facets widespread used and others not so wide. And this could be the starting point for this common IIIF index profile, to have buckets for who, where, when, and what. And interesting is object or media type, language, the holder of the cultural heritage object, and so on. And of course, besides of the facets, you need other stuff to feed your index to have alternative forms of names and titles and so on. And then maybe we get there sometime to have all the stuff grouped together, and a lot of people can use this in the way they want, not have to go to specific institutions first. Okay, thanks.
Thank you, Martin.